Hey, what's up, guys? It's us, and we're in the car because we're going grocery shopping. We're getting our errands done up for vacation, and we thought it'd be kind of cool to take you on a little grocery shopping trip.
So we are going to take you through what we're getting grocery-wise for vacation. We are leaving tomorrow. Take you through the store with us. Let's go. Roadblock. Gotta wait. Love and break.
Kissing is not a crime.
I'm not buying this, but can we talk about how much of a lie this is? It says keto friendly. Look at the carbs. That is not keto friendly. Taking the back roads.
We gotta get diapers too.
Yeah.
The baby.
We are on our way to go get a cooler. Right, yeah. I need it. Can we just say that Walmart is exhausting?
Every time.
Every time.
Especially if it's 1 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah. But it's like, what time is it? 11. And holy shit, man, these people. All right, guys.
Excuse us.
I wasn't crashing.
I think that's it, right? We don't need anything else? All right, I think this is gonna end our grocery haul. All right, let's check out. Made it out of Walmart. Only took us not that long. We are going to unbag all of our groceries and take you through what we got again, because I understand the videos were probably very choppy and not fantastic. So
we're trying not to be in people's way, but kind of get our shit done too at the same time. But yeah, typical Walmart experience, complete lack of self-awareness.
We will see you at home for the revealing of the groceries. Stay tuned.
Toodles.
Hey guys, what's up? We are back home and done with our grocery shopping for the day. Now we're just going to take you through quickly what we got today and why we got it.
Okay, so budget-wise, we allow ourselves like $100 to $150 a week between the two of us for groceries. So this one did run a little bit over budget.
I think it ended up like 170 something.
For 175.
Yeah.
Catches though, it's a vacation thing. So we did buy some extra stuff to kind of make vacation a little bit more fun, a little bit more comfortable. So we like diverse protein sources. We like to mix it up quite a bit, as you can see. So we went with chicken breast tenderloins this time around. Cool thing about these is they're way less fat than an actual chicken breast.
Yeah.
They're a lot leaner. So when you're deep into a diet, it means more food. It means more protein, less fat. Fats are delicious and you can spend them on stuff that you like to eat later on throughout the day, or more of like a treat. So we also got lean ground beef, 93.7, as lean as you can get. Guys, beef's expensive as shit right now. It's up like $2 from when we used to buy it. It was about $4 a pound. It was at six something today.
Yeah.
So
we stopped buying it for a while just because the prices went up once COVID started. And
fuck
then
COVID. Fuck COVID.
Then
20,
we stopped.
20.
Yeah, fuck COVID. Hashtag.
Fuck COVID. And then we got, we've been hooked on this lately, this butter bowl.
This is
all natural.
Amazing.
Ground turkey. You think it's going to taste like a Thanksgiving turkey blended up. And then you open it and you're like, oh, it's going to be more like a burger. But it's not. It's almost like a breakfast sausage.
Yeah. But without the fat.
Without the fat. And it's kind of cool because you could totally put it on like a bun with like lettuce, tomato, and onion.
It's so good.
Bomb. It's super satisfying. It's very savory.
Yeah.
Highly, highly, highly recommend
we're
this.
We're probably going to eat this even when we're not dieting.
Yeah. So. Like, it's delicious. I love it.
Yeah.
Then classic pork tenderloin. Why tenderloin? A, it's lean. B, it's a big cut. You can throw it in a crock pot. You can throw it in a Pyrex.
Yeah.
Really, it's versatile and it's so easy to prepare. It is a little expensive. It was like $10.50. But this is almost a 3-pound cut of meat. And that'll probably last us, depending on what else we eat throughout the day, a day or two.
Yeah.
Probably closer to 2 days for 3 pounds.
Yeah.
Because you got to think, we track, the way our diet works, we track all protein sources. So you're going to get protein in everything else. So it's really not just meat that you're eating. So next, how do we flavor the meat, okay? Guys, make friends with spices, right? You can learn to combine them on your own. We do that quite a bit, actually. But sometimes we get on these kicks with these little packets. And Walmart has all these nifty little flavor packets that you can pick up. They have Great Value brand. There's McCormick. My coffee down. So today we picked up this Southwest Ranch chicken. Kind of tastes like a taco. We got this fiery sriracha lime and garlic. This stuff is awesome. And a little goes a long way. Like, this is probably 2 days worth of like ample seasoning. I mean ample. Then we got this Caribbean jerk wing sauce.
We had some jerk chicken the other day and it was phenomenal. And now we're just like on a jerk kick.
but like other things you can use, it doesn't have to be a meat seasoning. They make little dressing additive packets. We like a garlic and herb one. It's like 13 cents a packet and it will flavor an entire tenderloin in a slow cooker, guys. And I mean flavor it. Like, it's not like, oh, it's kind of there. Like, no, man, you taste it. We also went with this G. Hughes. They have these sugar-free sauces and marinades. Macros are really low. I don't know if you guys can see that. It's like 1 carb per serving. So 24 carbs in the entire container.
And speaking of the jerk, I came across this, which is a jerk seasoning. And the macros are pretty awesome too. It has 1 carb, if you guys can see. It's like not, whatever. But it has like 1 carb in it. So that's pretty awesome. And it's jerk, so.
Yeah. So and the way we go about flavoring stuff, especially when it comes to like chicken and pork, because they're all pretty bland, is I'm a big fan of, I put it in the slow cooker, I don't add any water or anything to it, and I'll just do either like a dry rub with the flavor and let the juices and the meat mix with the dry rub and create a sauce. Or I'll just take this whole damn thing and dump it in there. So we like sandwiches. Who doesn't love Sammies? Everybody loves a good Sammy, which brings us to our next point. Mm-hmm. How do you make a sandwich while you're dieting? Well, there's a couple of ways. If you're doing a purely Walmart haul, we got this shit. There's also Thin Slim Foods, makes these awesome carb-free breads.
I'll show you.
They're not carb-free for us, because we do count fiber in our diet. More on that later. I won't get into the details on it. But we order them off the internet. It's a little bit pricey, but they make like these nice breads that are generally carb-free. They're actually high in protein. If you're doing keto.
Can you see the macros?
And you're doing the net carb thing.
It's delicious.
It's really handy, and they make noodles. They make like all sorts of like breakfast
pizza
rolls.
Pizza crust.
They also do waffles, which are surprisingly delicious.
Yeah.
Like they're not dry or gross. They're really tasty.
I think we tried like a brownie before. The brownie was okay.
It was kind of bland.
It was very bland though.
Yeah.
So I don't.
I'd rather.
But
like,
their breads and their pastas and their crusts are phenomenal.
The pizza
so
crust
if you're
is
dieting,
fantastic.
Yeah, go ahead and hit them up because they're a little bit expensive, but
when you're
for
dieting,
what you're getting. It's worth it.
Yeah. And it's especially if you're on keto. We made white pizza with their crust and it was
bomb.
It was something that I would eat anytime. Like,
yeah.
That's kind of like a bullwether for us. Like if the diet food is good, like would you eat this if you didn't have to? Yes. Then you nailed it. Like you're doing well. So to go with our burgers that we're going to have on vacation, sandwich thins. These are by Brown Berry. Honestly, the macros are pretty in line with like a Kaiser bun. Cool thing with it is they're a little bit less, a little bit leaner, a little less fat, that sort of thing. So, like, I mean, you're saving a few carbs. And when you're dieting and when you're getting deep into it, literally every gram counts at the end of the day when you want to have a treat.
Yeah.
New find today, actually, is these Joseph's pita breads. Here's the packaging. And these are pretty dope, guys. If you look at the back of this, you actually get a whole pita, and it's like 9 carbs, 1.5 grams of fat, and 6 protein. I love flatbread. I'll just eat this straight up. I'll just tear chunks off and snack on it. But obviously, you can do like pita pockets and stuff, you know, cut it in half, put your ground turkey in there, you know, with some homemade pico or chopped lettuce and onion, something like that.
Yeah.
And you got yourself a pretty good meal.
These okay, so
we love these.
Yeah, we love these. These are extreme wellness. We found these at our local Sparkle and just realized that Walmart carries them too, and I've never seen them before, so really exciting. They have a shit ton of fiber in them and they're delicious. They have the tomato basil flavor like this, they have a whole wheat, and they have a spinach and herb.
Yeah,
and they are all
fantastic. They toast up really good too, they get nice and crispy.
So we got a bunch of them for vacation.
You're beautiful.
You're beautiful.
You're beautiful. I love you.
I love you too.
Sorry, guys. Compliment your woman. Compliment your lady all the time. Never doubt her. Never disagree with her in public. Always, always, always have your lady six. I promise you, man. And she will have yours. Got your caboose, silly goose. And say dumb shit like that, and they love it. See, look at it. She's radiating. So adorable. So, on to the next thing. Lavash bread. There's that. These are pretty cool. Serving size is half a flatbread. I eat the whole thing. But, again, really cool macros on this. And half a bread, you get 1.5 fat. You get 8 carbs and 6 protein. Loaded
really
with
good protein.
Source. Like if meat's expensive these days, right? So maybe you're trying to ease back on the meat and you need protein from other sources. Great opportunity to make a sandwich and to put like another 12 protein in it. You guys think like most people are going to eat 4 to 6 ounces of protein per serving. 4 ounces of protein is 24 grams of protein basically.
Yeah.
4 ounces of meat mostly. So you think about that, that's like half of your protein just in sandwich. So you can load that up with a lot of other cool shit. Digress. So what we do is we actually get these little flavorings right here. Great value brand. You know, I just mixed it up, get a bunch of different stuff. The strawberries and cream's really tasty. Berry Blast. And what's really cool about this is they have a little bit of caffeine in them. And what I do pre-workout or intra-workout, kind of both, is I just take a shaker bottle, put flavorings in there, and add a little bit of salt to taste.
It's literally Gatorade.
You're making Gatorade, but the catch is our flavors are cooler. Every night, we like to have a treat. It's like kind of like a key to our diet. It gives you something to look forward to throughout the day. It's like trying to see like how like junk foody we can make it without it actually being junk food.
Yeah.
Right? So it's kind of like a cool little game we play. And I'm thinking the other night, like, what if we did like sugar-free pudding to add some like thickness and volume to it? And I feel like there's a Will joke right there. Everybody likes it thicker. It's always better. Down with the thickness. Thick thighs save lives. Whatever. So anyway, I got a bunch of different flavors. These were like the cool, two of the most exciting ones. French vanilla, or a vanilla and pistachio. And the cool thing is like these are really low in sugar. There's like 5 carbs in a serving, 20 per container. So what I thought of was like maybe mixing them with my berries. But these were like 50 cents a piece for the Jell-O brand and like 39 for great value. Dog. So then there's this. Carb Smart ice cream from Breyers. Not much to say. It's vanilla ice cream. It's low carb. Fats are a little bit up there. So I only use this when I have like kind of leftover fats for the day. But it's a pretty legit like a low carb ice cream. You get a lot for the serving size.
And it's
size.
Really good too.
And it's got a good flavor. I like to put my blueberries and cherries on top of it.
It tastes like normal ice cream.
Yeah. Probably not quite Jenny's level.
Jenny's isn't normal.
Yeah, but Jenny's you can't even make healthy. There's no point.
Yeah.
So then you notice we got other stuff. Fruit Twisters.
I love these. These taste like fruit roll-ups.
They're so good. Right? They're really satisfying.
It's so good. If you guys are interested, go try them because they're fantastic.
And then we got like Budget Saver popsicles. Serving size is like 2 popsicles. And it's like 14 carbs for 2 of them.
This?
Yeah, that's...
We don't usually do this, but we're going on vacation and I want to cook it while we're there. Angel's Food Cake. It's like fantastic for dieting.
It's fat-free. Decently low in carb.
It has a little bit of protein in it too.
Yeah.
But if you're dieting and you have a sweet tooth and you want like... junk food, berries, and Angel Food Cake. 100%.
We just discovered this. We are huge popcorn fans.
We love our popcorn.
Popcorn, a lot of it. So we normally just serve it out by like the tablespoon into like a little popcorn popper that we have. Sometimes it's really labor intensive. It's kind of a pain in the ass.
Yeah.
So just found these. Orville Redenbacher's Natural Simply Salted. Guys, it's popcorn. You know, you actually get quite a bit for the macros in it. We could probably do an entire video based off of actually how to measure popcorn. Remember how tedious that was at first? Like, is it for popped, unpopped? Like, it doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, but doing it in the bags is just so much easier.
Just throw it in there and you shake it up. It's really convenient.
Yeah, plus you don't have to do the dishes.
Yeah, I mean, it's maybe a little bit wasteful if you're trying to do the green thing, but...
Yeah. But when you get off work at 10 o'clock at night and you don't feel like spending a half hour in the kitchen preparing your last meal,
yeah,
like bags are the way to go, especially when their macros are that good.
Guys, I'm a carrot guy and you really can't go wrong with carrots. You get a lot of them. You can snack throughout the day. They do have carbs in them, a little bit of protein. But like this is 5 pounds of snacks right here. Prepared, peeled, ready to go. I actually get about 4.5, so you don't really lose a lot in the preparation process. And this was $3. So, I mean, and this bag, a 5-pound bag will last me...
probably a couple days.
Probably 3 or 4 days,
yeah,
depending on how hard I hit it. I usually eat about 20 ounces of carrots a day. I know it gets redundant, but like they're sweet. You can put salt on them. You can do a lot with them.
And they fill you up throughout the day, too, yeah, if you just snack on them.
They make a nice little snack.
Staying full.
Yeah. And it's like, you feel like you're getting away with it too. It's really good for adherence because it's a snackable vegetable. Really last up on the list is beverages and stuff. Pre-workout, every day, whatever. I'm a big coffee guy. And then creamer.
We like to try a new kind every time we get creamer, yeah. But we always have our go-to, like,
great value, butter cookie or vanilla caramel.
Yeah, but today this is toasted marshmallow mocha.
And then these things. I love these things. These little seltzer waters, because A, it's like a liter of fluids. B, it's cheap as shit. These are like 57 cents. And they come in all kinds of creative flavors. Like, here's a mandarin orange one. But there's nothing in them. There's like 2 carbs in the entire container. I don't even count that because
it's water.
Like, you burn that walking to the fridge, you know, like you're good. And so we got like peach, an orange cream flavor I've never seen before. All kinds of ones. I still have a ton left over from the last grocery store we went to. But I'm always drinking all these things. They're delicious and they're cheap.
Yeah. Like, we like doing this. I wanted to put in there just because when people say diet, they think like of oppression, like, which it can be. I especially have to feel good in it or else I won't see results. Like, I feel like I stress about it and then I just hold a lot of water weight. But like the way that we do our own macros, or the way that he did my macros, like, I don't feel oppressed at all. I am eating 1500 calories. Is that what it was? 1500 calories, which is not a whole lot. I actually last night was so full, like, I couldn't finish my popcorn, which is saying a lot because popcorn is the love of my life. Number 2 to you. Yeah, I think it's important to show you guys this because, I mean, yes, we're dieting and yes, we are eating
adherence
ice cream and whipped cream and angel food cake. And
so, like, when I was competing in strongman, and running RP regularly, did I perform better? Absolutely. Absolutely. Like, that's evidence-based. That's really scientific type shits. It's done by guys with a lot of credentials on their wall, and they're very, very smart people. You know, they have PhD or shit attached to their name. We don't. We're normal folks who live normal lives. Sometimes it gets hectic, man. And like you guys, you got kids, you got family obligations, you got jobs. Some of you have physically demanding jobs that don't let you go and, hey, I'm gonna go work out for 2 hours today. But you need to be in shape. So how do we balance everything out? So adherence is probably the way we approach it is key. Get your protein in and do what it takes to stick to that diet.
And that's exactly why we created Badger Clan too. We wanted to relate to the folks that are just like us. We're normal everyday people with a full-time job and we just don't have time to like take it to the max, like pro athletes. And like, no matter how much we like working out, because we do enjoy it, it's not our entire life. All right, we're gonna put this stuff in the refrigerator and wrap this up. If you guys enjoyed the video, don't forget to leave us a like and subscribe. What?
Yeah, subscribe.
Subscribe.
Smash that like button. Smash that.
Subscribe to our channel. Right here. Yeah, subscribe. Right in this area. But if you like the diet hauls, comment, let us know, or shoot us a message. We will continue to do them if you want to see more, or if you have any other ideas for videos.
Or challenge us, guys. Say like, hey, I really like to eat this food. Can you make this healthy for me? There's no guarantees there, but we'll do our best to make it in a way that could probably fit
a lifestyle. We do it every day.
With tons of hacks, guys.
But anyway, okay, we are signing off.
We're signing off. Be fierce.
Stay fierce.
Peace.
Peace.
Enough.